Meanwhile, in Germany and also Belgium, areas of Europe, they had some devastating flooding that we talked about on the program. And you know what? It's sort of shocking. It turns out climate change actually contributed to it. So the violent and deadly flooding in Germany and Belgium last month was an extremely rare event, according to scientists, but it was one that was made more likely by climate change. Scientists found that the record rainfall that led to the flooding, including a 24-hour total of 3.5 inches in the Ahr and Erft river valleys in Western Germany, was a 400-year event, meaning in any given year, there was a 1 in 400 chance of such a downpour occurring in the region. So it will still be rare, even as of right now, with all of the damage that's been done to the climate. But the event is about 1.2 to 9 times more likely now than it would have been about a century ago before we did so much more damage to our climate. So it's more likely. It is also more intense. Researchers found that warming has increased the intensity or amount of precipitation of such a heavy rainfall by 3% to 19%. And at 2 degrees Celsius, the intensity would increase another 0.8% to 6%. Both findings are in keeping with a basic fact of climate change that warmer air holds more moisture. And this is, look, they're analyzing it in terms of probability and intensity, but this is significant. In those most recent floods that we covered, 220 people were killed, mostly in Germany. And so these becoming more likely and them becoming even worse when they do happen is likely to cause significant loss of life, Bridget.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it just goes to show, like, climate catastrophe is not something that's down the line, you know, many, many years from now. It's here now. And I think, like, what you just shared is kind of a startling example of exactly that.
Exactly. Yeah. And again, we will remind people that that climate report came out just a couple of weeks ago. It talked about the, you know, we've got I forget exactly the terminology they use, but there's like a flashing red alarm for how bad it is right now. And no, nobody's talking about it. I get it. Afghanistan happened, like, every week there's more news, but we also have these extreme weather events, the flooding, the fires that continue, the flooding that happened in China, for instance. The Mediterranean had all of their fires, an entire island basically was destroyed. So this continues and it's going to continue until we actually do something about it. But for now, meanwhile in such happy music, but unfortunately in Japan, the world's fastest roller coaster will remain indefinitely suspended following multiple shattered bones sustained by those who rode on it. So this is the Do-Dodonpa, and I want to show you a little bit of video. This is from the Theme Park Reviews YouTube channel. This is what the launch of this roller coaster looks like.
Launch time!
Oh, crap!
Yeah, so it's fast. How fast? Well, actually, it goes so fast that when you get off, you've gone back in time. You can get back on as many times as you want. It's that fast. No, it's really fast, though. And it's actually dangerously fast because since December, at least 6 riders sustained bone fractures after riding it. It's a roller coaster that goes at, and I swear to God, this is what they say, super death speed in the country's popular Fuji-Q Highland Park. That was according to a park's operator. They call it super death speed. 4 of the riders say they broke their neck or their back, apparently. So it was built way back in 2001. It goes from 0 to 112 miles per hour in 1.56 seconds, making it the fastest accelerating roller coaster in the world. But the park said it was the first time riders broke their bones on the ride since it went into operation 2 decades ago. So they don't know exactly what's happening, although I don't know. I would speculate it's something to do with the fact that apparently it gives you comparable G forces to what astronauts experience during a rocket launch. Maybe that's part of it. But anyway, Bridget, somehow the super death speed has resulted in injuries. It's a real mystery.
Yeah, it could be the super death speed. That might be what's doing it.
It might be. I think it's the speed. I think it's the speed that's doing it.
I have to say, this might be an unpopular opinion, but when I was growing up, I loved roller coasters. The faster, the bigger, the more like horrible looking, the better when I was a kid. And it wasn't until I broke my tooth on a ride called the Backward Rebel Yell at King's Dominion in Virginia. Hopefully they've changed that name by now, but wasn't until breaking my tooth on a roller coaster that I stopped riding them. But younger me would have seen this and been like, yes, please, I want to try it out.
Is the Rebel Yell the yell they make when their bones break?
Yes.
Sounds dangerous. Anyway, look, apparently they had gone many years without injuries. So let's just get that out up front. And overall, statistics from the International Association of Amusement Parks and Attractions show that the likelihood of being seriously injured, not like just your tooth, so Bridget wouldn't be counting these numbers, of a roller coaster in a US amusement park is about 1 in 15.5 million rides. So on the one hand, it is super unlikely that you will be injured. On the other hand, I watched that Final Destination movie back in the day, so I'm never getting on one again. Why is this happening? Well, some people are speculating that riders are leaning forward and that caused them to be injured. It's a good theory. Sort of doubt that for the first 20 years nobody leaned forward, so it doesn't necessarily convince me. It is possible that wear and tear is causing it. We also have theories in our chat with Brooke Marks saying that we, where's the comment? It's because we've all been sitting around doing nothing and their bodies are deteriorating like the rest of us. Someone said we're all becoming mush people. So I don't know, maybe we're less capable of experiencing this, but I feel like it doesn't have to be that fast. Like a supercar goes 0 to 60 in like 3 or 4 seconds. That seems fast enough for me. I don't think that you need to double this. So anyway, it's suspended right now, Bridget. Perhaps they'll be able to figure out what's causing the injuries and bring it back. But I worry that a broken neck or a back today could be someone actually dying in a couple of years. So that's the worry.
Yeah, I mean, nobody wants to get on a roller coaster and then have it be the last choice they ever made. So hopefully they're able to figure it out. But would you ride this if they were able to get it sorted out? Would you ride this?
Maybe, I don't know. That did look pretty cool with the video. I'm not the biggest roller coaster person, but that did look pretty cool. We'll see, maybe.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.